Welcome to AirSpace from the Smithsonian's National Air and Space Museum. I'm Nick.
I'm Emily.
And I'm Matt.
One of the best-known names in early aviation is Amelia Earhart. That's in part because she was a record-breaking pilot, but it's also because she used her platform to speak out about aviation and women's rights.
Someone else who was really famous at the same time was First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt. What's less well known is that Eleanor and Amelia were friends, and they had similar tactics for raising awareness of the things they cared about.
One of the essential commonalities that Eleanor Roosevelt and Amelia Earhart had was that it wasn't about them. And they also understood how to use media in a way to promote, in an accessible way, in an engaging way, the challenges that they wanted the country to address.
Although women as yet have not taken full advantage of its use and benefits, air travel is as available to them as to men.
When Amelia would take these extraordinary flights, it wasn't about, oh, look at me, you know, I'm the one that followed Lindbergh. You know, aren't I cool? It's like, oh, look at what together we have been able to accomplish. Look what aviation can do. Look what women can do if given the chance. Look what this opens up for us. You know, I am somebody who has achieved a dream that should be accessible to all people. It was Amelia as a vehicle, as a conduit to talk about aviation, to talk about women in science. Okay, with Eleanor, it was never about her. It was about the topic that she was using the media to promote. Even in her daily newspaper column, she was talking about other people, even though it was called My Day. She would use her fame to support, introduce, and elevate issues, other leaders, unknown Americans who had risked themselves to do good.
May I hope this movement will spread throughout all branches of applied science and industry, and that women may come to share with men the joy of doing.
Yeah, and I think they both became incredibly iconic in their own day and have really remained cultural icons even, you know, so many decades after their deaths.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.